or can you discuss involvement? It's a lot of that, jumping through this life. It's a good thing. And I think there's a great effect.
You know, like, you're wearing purple, and have you heard the song Start Wearing Purple by Gogol Bordello? You know, like, the band Gogol Bordello? It's, yeah, maybe not, like, the Eastern European?
I don't even know that.
Okay, I'll, you don't even know, but you know the band, like, the copycat is Jumple, and so they sing, so they're amazing, like, the high energy, and they sing, like, the gypsy songs, Balkan style. And they're very, very cool. You should check them out on the internet. But we have the band in Toronto. They're trying to copy this, their band. And so they have the same kind of music. And sometimes they, well, the most famous song is the Start Wearing Purple. So you're wearing purple. And on every concert, they sing this song, like the Jumpo is from Toronto. And they're our friends because they're Russian. That they're from Eastern Europe and they're Russian, so but they sing in English, and every week they have a show, and it's free. I don't know, if you want, I may tell you where it is, but then you will check it out.
Yeah, the safest way first to check it out on internet, right? If you want to go or not, you know.
Well, you know, like it's free, so you cannot lose anything. Yeah. And it starts at 9.
You just want to know whether it's really far from.
Yeah. And usually.
This is how I do. I know I'm free. I'm just first. I go online. I always check everything, like, because if I go with a girl, right? So I'm in charge of her. I'm in charge of her like safety. So I have to check everything. Because it's like, I know, maybe I have a little, but it's like, I'm telling, so I want to be sure that we will have a great time, right, so, and that it will be safe, you know, and that, you know, we will have memories, you know, like, this is how I like it, but people are different, so he's not like this, so he's like, because he has a lot of friends, artists, famous artists here in Toronto, so this is how I met him, actually, so we were at the concert, and, he was hanging out with those guys, you know, I just walked up to them, so yeah, guys, great job, so this is our story, how we met. Can I ask you for a little advice? So, because we are guys, I asked him today, he's a cool guy, but he couldn't help me, because it's, I think, I need a female perspective. It's about the girl. Okay, it's like the story is very short. It's just I had a party at my place. My friend came from LA, and we did. I don't drink myself, but I like to mix drinks a lot because a lot of people have fun, you know. And I was mixing drinks. My friends was mixing drinks, and there was one girl, and she got too much, you know. And she got really drunk, you know. And, because I'm the host, I'm responsible for everything going on. So I just said, you know what? I'm gonna drive, you know. Okay, but just stay here overnight, and in the morning you can do whatever you want, right? So I did that. I walked her to another room, so I went to the bed, and I was about to leave, and she's like, Ilya, don't leave. I like you. Like, you know, but if the person is drunk, you talk to that person is. If she were like a kid or something, like, really, I just bring you some water, just relax and it's time to rest. And I'm walking out of my room, was about to walk out of my room, and she's like, again, really, you know, I really, really, really like you. People are like, hey, come, we're all waiting for you. And then I'm like, okay, just hang on for a second. I'll bring you some water and we'll talk about it. And she's like, you don't understand. I really like you. I love you. And I'm like, what? And she's like, that's out. Yeah. So I'm like, okay, that can happen if you're drunk. So I closed the door. So in the morning, so I woke up at 10, around 10, so she left already. I was like, okay, you know, this happens. So people are drunk, people are just doing things, you know. I just have to spirit, you know, I like when people enjoy life, you know. I don't want anybody to feel like not comfortable around me. So but she texted me recently. She texted me, she sent me an SMS, she said, Ilya, I wanna meet you. I wanna talk about what's happening, and I wanna talk about my feelings. And it's really serious, I think. So and I know perfectly where I want to be, so she's, don't get me wrong, okay, so I can't believe that I asked her for that, because she's an amazingly beautiful woman. She's very tall, like, she's into art, she likes money making, like, I like money taking, and she likes giving and everything. I like this too, and something is missing, you know, we're a good friend, but something is missing, so there is, you know, from friend to girlfriend, you gotta do this step. And there is something missing, so I never was able to do that thing. So I want to tell her that I want to stay with my friends, that I want to tell her that we're friends. But do you think, I don't want to hurt her, but do you think I should tell her? Should I tell her the truth, or should I say that I'm dating somebody so I can have you with you, or would be, so you are like, woman, so I will appreciate so your perspective. How you see that? If I told you, like, for example, of course, you know, so you're like, I love you, right? So, and I'm like, oh, thank you.
friend. How would you feel about that?
I think it's okay.
It's okay?
Yeah. Because you want to be just friend, right?
Yeah. Because I talked to guys, you know, and guys, they are very, very different. So they said the advantage of it, if you understand what I mean. And that's the thing that you're not interested in. Like, I don't know, guys, in what kind of world you live. For me, it's much harder to find a friend than to take advantage of somebody. Just, you know, it's easier. Much I'm very upset a bit about this, and I think I will follow your advice. So I don't want my concept to tell them. I do think we should be here to stay away like for 2 months, not to see each other for 2 months, so that she will figure out whether she really like love me or it was just alcohol and summer. You know, maybe we should see each other for 2 months. For example, if people who drink a lot of alcohol, they want to quit drinking alcohol, so you tell them, don't go to the bar, because if you will start drinking again, because you're at the bar, everybody drinking. So the same with the girl, but maybe I should tell her this, we will not see each other for next month, and then after that, so it will be good either for her, forget me, or do the same. Is it a good idea? But if it's for you, if I told you, okay, we're just friends, right?
Yeah.
Let's do not see each other. Would you feel offended or would you feel hurt?
Not hurt.
No?
So, you are friends for 2 months?
No. Well, I knew her maybe for 3 years.
3 years?
Yeah. First, she was dating one of my friends.
Oh.
Then they broke up. Then she was just hanging out with us, you know, just like whenever we go somewhere, we go to a restaurant, you know, we go for sushi or something. Yeah. So we're talking about this. She likes art. We were going a lot to the there is AGO. What's the Ontario?
Art Gallery of Ontario.
Art Gallery of Ontario. So we spend a lot of time there. I like, you know, to see the works of artists. Yeah, but okay. I think that will go.
No.
Yeah.
If the relationship for over three years, maybe she will be able to understand your feeling, I think.
But no, I think she, because I wanted to tell her first, you know. No, I will tell you. Tell her like what you told me. Because my main concern is just I don't want to hurt her, right? I can do something that she just, you know, just to make sure that she's not hurt, so I can tell her. I thought maybe I should talk about her girlfriend or something. I asked one girl, like, can you act as if you're my girlfriend? Oh, really? She said, okay, yeah, explain the situation. So, but now I think it's too much. You know, because we know everything like about relationships. How do you learn about that? Did you have a lot of relationships, or it's just like the natural thing? Is your mom somehow taught you all this about the relationships? Because did you have a lot of like boyfriends or
no?
So how did you learn? How did you learn? Yeah. So because obviously when you speak, so I kind of trust you, you know, because you speak with confidence. You speak about the relationships, okay? It's not even the matter of the language, just the way you speak, so it just like, somehow you calm me down. You know, I was a bit, if you notice, I was a bit nervous about this, now you calm me down. So, I got this energy of water from you. Yeah, because my energy is fire. Not really, it just balanced me out. Look, I got so, that's cool, I like it. Yeah.
Sorry, I can't give you good advice.
No, it's a good advice. No, I think you know what. I will let you know for the workout. So today's what? Today's Monday, right?
Monday, we're meeting on Wednesday.
Ah, Wednesday.
So I'll give you. We'll probably will exchange like emails. So I'll let you know. Hopefully, we'll be comfortable with that. And so I just let you know. So I think it will work. Yeah. So, where do you live here in Toronto? No, where do you live?
You are from the east.
Yeah, yeah.
Funny thing.
So,
Eastern country.
Absolutely. He lives in the west, I live in the east.
Really?
Yeah. Because in the east, like, it's because he, as I told you, like, involved in many activities with artists. There are more, like, going on, like, in the west part of Toronto than the east. Of course. So, what kind of people live in that area? Coxwell?
Hello, welcome to Take the Mission.
I've been here before, but my nephew, I'm just bringing him through.
Okay, so take a look.
So, what was your favorite shopping place? What's the
store? Do you have a video on the other
room? In here, yeah.
Yes, there is, that's a VC.
I think, yeah, we have only here and here, and I think they're different.
Thank you. Because normally girls
person, you know, if you, because I cannot leave my place, so we should hang out, you know. I need a new dresser, you could help me with that, because I hate shopping, but I like, no, I like have, I like beautiful outfits. I hate shopping, you know, because, and I know all girls like shopping, because you've been to eating centers, there's so many stores, you know, and if you could be my guy, shopping, like, this is, like, a cool store, like, because I, the way I do it, I have normal clients, like, with a stylist or something, and just, can you, like, really help me? I actually called her, okay, this is good, I just try it on, like, yeah, it's cool, okay, I like it, go, I just pay that it's gone. Maybe, just, like, just for fun, kind of, if you work this weekend, maybe, what about this Saturday, so what are you doing this Saturday, so?
From Friday, yeah. I will go to Green Day,
What about
how long?
Just 4 days.
Oh, okay. What about to Wednesday?
Yeah, Wednesday, right?
So we're not doing it on Wednesday.
You're meeting this girl on Wednesday.
Oh, like it's in the morning.
Okay. We do it like after, like, let's say, 3 o'clock. After 3 o'clock.
What's
the best time to, because I like, you know, I don't like to make people uncomfortable, so what's the best time for you to go and jump in and find the most beautiful dresser ever?
I usually finish my class at 3:45.
3:45?
Yeah.
And where is your school? Okay, so young and lore, then we can meet young and lore. But we can meet young and lore, so then do you want me to meet you after school, or is it good to, then we can eat first something. Do you eat a lot? No?
I
don't eat a lot, I like to eat.
Actually, I always
have. Really?
Yeah, I
have. So we can do that? Oh my god, so there are a lot of cool places just here. We have a phone number that you can help us go move forward to. Yep, maybe we can help you down here. From Machu Picchu. Yeah, so my friend, the one that lives in Tokyo, Asuko, Asuko-san. She brought me from Machu Picchu, so she went on a trip to Mexico. Oh, yeah, Phil, sorry.
Actually, I'm thinking about
travel
to Machu Picchu.
Oh, really? I can ask her. So she went by herself? No, we don't want two Japanese girls. They went there, and whoa, they got a lot of cards. And she didn't spend a lot of money, so she was really smart. So she figured out everything. It was really good deal to go there, and whoa, why is it really respect? Yeah, it is.
Yeah, you can be a good guest. I'm telling you, because my mother, before she started working for this travel agency, when she was young, she was performing, she was a ballerina in Russia. So Russia is famous for ballet.
Yeah.
And she did a lot of dancing, so she made me go to many like dance schools and because I'm a guy, so I said, no, I want to go to karate, wrestling, you know. Then she said, she gave up, okay, you're going to go there, but you will remember me when you will be like 16 years old, 18 years old, because you don't understand how what I'm doing for you. I was like, mom, I just want to be a strong guy, you know, I just want to. And I did 3 years wrestling. My nose is still like not breathing correctly because it's like really little harsh sport. And what's happened when I got 18, I realized I said, I'm so stupid, idiot, you know, because when you go to a dance school with one boy and nine girls, beautiful girls, and they like sophisticated girls, smart girls, this is how I like it, like, and they also like they know how to present themselves. I like it, you know, like well women. I used to take salsa here. So what do you do for fun? So what is your what do you do, like, do you have any hobbies or?
Yeah, I like playing tennis and then I like traveling.
So you are rich, right? You are very rich.
Rich?
You have such a hobby to travel for. So much and it doesn't have an effect on me. I'm like, why should I spend money? It's so expensive. It's in genes, you know, it has to do with my thought about it. So, yeah.
Okay.
But you're not vegetarian, no?
Vegetarian?
No. Can you cook? But I can cook it very well.
Oh, really?
I wanted to be a chef. I was thinking maybe I would still do that. I thought maybe, because I enjoy it. Like, this is what I do, so he knows that. So, I go. Normally, I get the friends at my place, I call it cooking party. So, and I have the friends from different like nations. So one, like we cook different meals, you know, and just learning culture through this, and it's such a cool thing. And I like it to have very healthy, you know, low fat, a lot of vitamins, you know, just because I'm 55, right? So now, look, I don't look my age. But you're like 23, right?
No.
You're not 22.
No. What did you say your age?
My age is not. Okay, your age was 27. 27?
Yeah.
Is it your age too?
No.
What's your age?
No.
Okay, it's, I don't want to make
it. Not really. I'm almost born.
Almost?
I was born 1983.
I remember it was the year of a dragons. Mm-hmm. Chinese, like, I think it was dragon or something. What was that? So you are 26, right? Oh, great. This is how I am, you know. I see right into the person's core, like right into inside. This is how, because I don't know. So you're very like young inside, so it's like me. But I drink a lot of green tea, so maybe that as well. You also probably you like green tea? What's your favorite one?
Matcha.
Matcha?